Hey guys, I am here walking the baby. Charles is at the park with the other two kids. Wanted to share something. I'm reading Angels and Demons by Dan Brown. I read that book by randomly picking it up in my 11th grade AP English class. It's important to know I failed AP English in 11th grade and had to go to summer school. But you know what? That F actually taught me a lot. I read The Scarlet Letter in that class. I read The Great Gatsby in that class. God, Huckleberry Finn, guys. Well, I didn't read that one. I cliff noted that one. What else did I read? You know what? That class was a lot of essays. That's why I was not good at that. I read Huckleberry Finn. No, I didn't. I read The Scarlet Letter. It's probably like the one story I would love to take and write an amazing screenplay out of it, because honestly, guys, you need some help. And I'm standing in the shade right now, but I wanted to share this because I'm wearing my church shirt regarding what the next decade of my church's mission and vision is. And it made me start thinking about the book I told you in the beginning of this video, Angels and Demons, and how there's a speech in it that has completely changed my life, because it talks about science and religion, science and God. And I have always believed in my core, and it's because of this book, that science and religion are just two different philosophies trying to explain the exact same story. In the book, there's this part that says, science, we cannot keep up with you. Religion is tired of trying to set up goalposts on whether or not the inventions that we are creating as mankind gets smarter and asks more and more questions. Guys, I read this book 12 years ago and it said, now with everything that's been developing, it's incredible the amount of innovation that we've had. But that book said that just because there's a book that says how we can build an atomic bomb, where is the morality to ask us whether we should? That's what we have to question. Because, yeah, look, in the book it's a fiction book, but it has a lot of Catholicism that's actually correct. So that's why, that book influenced me. And that's why I'm having a conversation about it on my phone, talking to you, that I'm gonna upload on YouTube. So yeah, so there's this part in this book that says, science has reduced our rainbows to wavelengths, and people ask if there's a God. And in the book it said, I ask you to grab your telescope, look up to the stars, and tell me how there is not a God. That people would rather believe a mathematical impossibility versus some bigger, amazing creator having his hand in all of this. In all of this, guys. In all of this. Yeah. That's my belief. Yeah. Yeah. And I'll talk. I'll discuss. But tell me what happened. Like, explain to me the Big Bang Theory, science people. Because I'm a scientist. I call myself a scientist. I call myself a philosopher. I call myself everything. That's why it doesn't hurt me when people call me names, because I have bigger names that I call myself. So to my haters that are still watching, I do it for you guys. I do it for you. You guys fire me up. Keep sending the hate, yo. It's just gonna make me get fucking even more better than you guys. But anyway, that's all where I thought. And look, you've upset my baby because you fired me up. Yeah, 4 minutes and 45 seconds of just complete nonsense. No, it's not nonsense. It's my thoughts, kids. It's for you. I love you, kids. I cannot wait till you guys are reading and we have book clubs. Literally, your mom is gonna have you guys read so much and write papers. Oh man, school is gonna be easy compared to what your mother's gonna have you reading. Aristotle, Plato, The Unexamined Life is Not Worth Living. Those are the things that we're gonna challenge, guys. I'm so excited. Sarah, Charlie, Sam. Yeah, we're gonna fucking learn. And you guys are 4, 3, and 9 months at the park right now with your dad, not realizing that your mom is talking to you on YouTube. So again, guys, anyone else is watching, the haters have gone away, because kids, you're gonna have haters, but just when you learn from your mom, you know, after a while, it just becomes noise, kids. So I love you, kids. It turned into something else. It was supposed to be well thought out, but it wasn't. I love you, kids. I'm wearing a shirt from the church that pretty much made your mother become a Christ follower. And this is what the shirt says: lift up Jesus so that the world might believe. That's all we want, is that they might believe. I love it, kids. Kids, remember faith and love and hope. All the things that are invisible are the things that are worth grabbing for. Love you guys. Again, anybody else watching this in the virtual sphere that is the internet, thank you. I'm rooting for you. I'm so rooting for every single one of you to win. And I know I come off as, I don't know what I come off as to people, but I really root for you. I'm standing in front of these cars driving by unfazed, because it doesn't matter. Guys, there's billions of people on Earth. Honestly, no one's really watching you unless they're obsessed with you. You don't want those kind of people in your life. God bless you, kids. Again, this time, I'm going to say goodbye. Love you. If you're not first, be last. Thank you for watching. Anybody else? Bye.